All right then, guys, welcome back to some more Mafia 3. This is episode 24. Wow, we have come a long way in this playthrough. And needless to say, still thoroughly enjoying this game. I hope you're all enjoying this playthrough as well as much as what you did previously. So, just a kind of little disclaimer here. I always drop these in videos, guys, but it is actually to do with the game, so don't worry. I always try and what I try and do with Lincoln's clothing is give him a new outfit for every episode. That's what I try to do. So, yeah, that's kind of my aim. So don't worry, I don't play anything off screen. Like, if I do, it's a little bit of free roam. I don't do any missions or anything without telling you guys. But yeah, we've got to go speak to Bear Donnelly and see what he has to say. Also, guys, just in case you couldn't already tell, I do have a really bad cold. It's still lingering, basically. So I'm over the worst, but I've still got a bit of a cough and obviously the sore throat.
Decided it was time to branch out. Not really a lot for me in that organization anymore.
So what's your new line?
Mind-melting narcotics. And I hear the best are coming out of Frisco. PCP. And it's cutting into my business.
Okay. So where's the operation?
Beats the hell out of me. But a while back, Miss Olivia Marcano hired a top-notch chemist named Bobby Bastian. Tasked him with upgrading her operations, which will make it impossible for the small-time cooks to compete. Hell, they even got taxis delivering their shit.
If I can get to Bastian's dealers, maybe they'll give him up. Tell me something I can use against them.
That ain't all. Word is Miss Marcano brought in a couple other eggheads from San Francisco. Get rid of them, and Bobby Bastian's gonna find himself nice and fucked. Put a beating on some of Bastian's guys, and maybe they'll tell you something useful.
Okay, so if I'm not mistaken, we've got to go after somebody called Bastian. All I know is that he's running some kind of business, and as per usual, he's using taxis and stuff. Just want to get this out there. I'm pretty sure you can pick this up because he's laying very close to me. My little Frenchie Oscar is in the room with me. If you watch my vlogs, you'll see all about him. Shout out to my vlogs as well, guys, just while I'm here. Just if you want to see any kind of behind the scenes stuff about my life, about what I do and how I execute these videos, go and give my vlogs a bit of a watch. A bit of a watch, does that make sense? But yeah, Oscar joins me whenever I'm recording because I only record when I'm home alone. And when I'm home alone, the dog comes and chills with me. He usually chills with me anyway, to be fair, but more so when I'm at home, when it's just me and him in the house, obviously. He'll come get on my bed and have a nap, and I'm literally at my desk, which is half a foot away from my bed. No, I'm not gonna, it's about 2 feet away from my bed. So yeah, I have him with me. He does snore. He's a French bulldog, guys. He has the snorting noise. It sounds like a little pig. It's not me snoring. I haven't got some guy in my bed either, so don't worry, stop your conspiracy theories here. Literally, it's my little dog, okay? So if you pick anything up, I do apologize. It probably makes it a bit funny because you know what's going on and you know who it is. But yeah, hence why I do kind of voiceover commentary. You guys can pretty much tell now, it's easier to edit this out. So we are looking at these guys and I literally just almost got caught. There aren't many of them. I'm kind of trying to be a little bit more braver now. So we've got his attention, and he's the one that we need to interrogate. He's the one that's going to hopefully give us the information. I just kind of need to. That could have gone a bit more smoothly, but the rest of the hit squad now. See the plan. The way that this works out well.
Tell me about Bastian's PCP business.
We've been moving the speed around town using taxis. Last I heard, the boss was keeping the cash drops in the dispatch garage.
Okay, so it's speed the moving. we're in the speed business here. But yeah, the main purpose of that then, see, even though I feel like I kind of wasted a bit on the hit squad, but because I'd been spotted, like the hit squad can take care of everybody else while I do that interrogation there. So that, you know, that's my way of looking at things. Just gonna pick up, clear the scene as usual. Just pick up any money. Ooh, a basketball. pitch. You know, court, not a pitch, Jesus Christ. I'm sorry, guys. I'm so, like, un-American. A basketball pitch, really? Anyway, we head back to the car. Kind of, probably one of the nicest cars in the game, I have to say. I'm not a fan of the cars in this game. But some of them are really smart, like the one, I'd go for that, what we're in now. Anyway, back in the car, guys, on to the next bit, and as you can see, it's just damage time now, so just doing whatever damage we can to the business to lure Bastion out of his hiding, and then whack him, obviously, and take over his business. Okay, we have arrived. I can't wait to see how that mission is going to pan out when we take down Marcano. I really hope that we have Vito, Cassandra, Burke with us as well when we do it. I really want to see that. I think it'll just be awesome. I hope it's a really good kind of cutscene. I've seen some already, like really good cutscenes in the game, and it just kind of makes it like a film, to be fair. But yeah, it's time to call the boys, because I'm not feeling going this one alone, not going to lie. So we're at like a taxi rank by the looks of it. Don't forget, that guy was saying they're pushing like all of the speed through taxis, so that's a madness, that's an absolute madness. Can you imagine like that happening today? That would just be... It would be unreal. Oh my god, I just literally was just about to take down that guy. Reflex is not on point here. Right, let's go. To be fair, not that many left. At all. Guys, one of my favourite little kind of one-liner, you know, what other characters say, is what the hit squad say when they kill one, and it's like, "Gone with the devil now, motherfucker." It's like my favourite. It gets me literally every time I hear it. I just burst out laughing. It gets me every single time. I don't know why. I think it's his voice, his accent. It's just the way that he says it. It's so funny. I love it. It might just be, you guys are like, I'm really not amused by this, but it just tickles me every single time. It gets me every single time. Anyway, we have only gone and cleared up another place. I was thinking, you know, like, thinking back now, maybe what I should have done is damage the cars as well. I wonder if that would help, because obviously they said, but then again, usually damageable stuff that's going to take money off for you, you know, the overall like amount of damage that you've got to do, money, usually they're highlighted, aren't they? So, and the cars weren't highlighted, but I thought that would make a good, like, I could just blow one up and have like a chain reaction going on, and then like that would obviously take down a lot of people as well. So on to the next one. Okay, so we have arrived. Please tell me. Yeah, right, just climb straight over there. Is this going to be a stealthy mission, maybe, guys? I would like to try a big mission like this, all guns blazing. I think I've dealt with harder. Like, I'm such a little chicken sometimes when I just always call the hit squad. I do, and I kind of like, sometimes I just feel like I wish I could just kind of do more, you know, but the hit squad are there to use at my own kind of, you know, beck and calling, so why not? I just think, right, we've definitely given ourselves away now. You have to make sure, like, your first shot is obviously a good one, because... And that was literally it. That's literally the lot. That's everything done. Oh my god, don't... Jesus. Right, better back off a little bit. I literally almost just shot then, and I thought, oh shit, no. Okay, we've got to destroy this vehicle as well. But yeah, it's kind of... do you know, I actually don't know how to work some of the stuff in this game. I was going to shoot it, and then I thought, that's just a waste of bullets, so we'll drop a bomb on it. Molotovs don't actually work, do they, on vehicles? They might do, it might just be me being a total dimwit and doing it wrong. But yeah, sometimes it's quicker just throw a grenade on it. I'm just going to get that. I think that's cash upstairs. Gonna get that. I can remember, like, earlier on in the game, and I was collecting all this cash, and I was like, do I even need this money? Like, literally, what does it do? Does it buy me anything? I know you can buy weapons as well, but, like, I use most of my money on the hit squad and helping get rid of the police. Like, I think there's two things you can use to help get rid of the police, and I used those three. It's mainly on the hit squad, though. Like, they definitely have about 80% of my money, I think. Anyway, that's another one done. And we've got to go and do that little bit more damage. The main reason I do sort of, obviously keep swiping every single place, make sure I get every single bit of, like, money that I can and doing maximum damage, is so I can get these done a little bit quicker for you guys. Because it's all fun, but I feel like if I did every single one, I feel like I'd get a bit bored after a bit. By the way, I watched James Buckley, obviously, play Jay from The Inbetweeners, and he has a YouTube channel now, which is just surreal. I love it. His channel's called Completed It Mate, so if you haven't seen it and you're an Inbetweeners fan back in the day, go and check it out. It's a good watch. Like, he put some good content out there. But anyway, James was playing GTA. I think he's actually stopping it now because he said he wasn't getting enough views. So go and watch them and go and tell him that he needs to carry on doing the playthrough, because I watched it and I really enjoyed it. But yeah, I was watching his video, and his driving was atrocious. I thought I was a bad driver in games. When I actually try, I'm a really good driver in games. So it gives me a bit of faith, because I haven't got a driving license, IRL. I'm too scared, and I'm literally like, I just crash all the time. But I know it's only a video game, but I'm actually really good in video games at driving. So maybe it's a sign. I'm hoping it's a sign, guys. But yeah, anyways, I think they're around the back here.
What? All dressed up and no one to whack.
Tell you what, I'm watching Prison Break at the minute, guys, and you know Teddy, the pedophile in the series, one of the characters, and not proper characters, but like one of the enemy voices, really reminds me of him, like his voice. It's so creepy. I hate him so much. And if you know who I'm talking about, anyway, and if you've also seen Hunger Games. He's in Hunger Games. Like, I only worked this out a couple days ago. Long story short, one of my my best friend's, like, boyfriend looks like Tweener from Prison Break. And I was kind of looking at other characters, and I was thinking, like, oh, who else looks like in Prison Break looks like someone I know that I could rip out of. So I was looking at that actor's name as well, of Tweener, trying to get more pictures and just send them to my friend, and I come across, obviously, Teabag. He was on there, and I was just curious. I was like, oh, what else has he been in? And I saw him in Hunger Games. So, like, guys, if you know, comment in the comments down below. I was so shocked, literally. Like, I was really, really... I was thinking, who the fuck is he in Hunger Games? I was expecting him to look, like, just as he does, and he really doesn't. Sorry about the dog barking then, guys. Little Oscar, the little terror. If you watch my, What is this vlog going to be called that I'm currently doing? I guess it's gonna be it's gonna be the getting FIFA 18 vlog. If you give that a watch, you'll see the proof that it is Oscar in my videos that barks and snores and pretty much whatever else he does behind me. Yeah, that's your proof. Okay, so go and watch that vlog and you'll soon see. I don't think I actually have to blow that up, you know. Oh yeah, I do. It says destroy. You know, I'm so blind. Jesus. There we go. Boom. Done. We are done. We've done another one. Another one. DJ Khaled. And we're on to the next and hopefully, possibly last one, maybe last two more to go. It depends how big they are, I suppose, and how much damage we can do in each one. Because in some, it's literally like, oh, steal a bag of money, and then that's it. Okay, so there's like a house, I think. Yeah, it's definitely a house. And... I think we're gonna go stealthy with this one, guys. What I am gonna do is kind of cut the stealthy bit, like, so it's action, 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 and not waiting, and then, you know, like, now. So, one of them almost saw me, so I've just come back here a bit. I'm just trying to assess which way to go first. It might be easier in this way, I think. Oh my god, why? I think he's coming because he was like the closest one. But I hate that so much. So he's gonna come. I think if we wait here for him, that should be okay. I hope. Yeah, he's coming around that way, so that's good. And he thinks I'm literally there, so we should be able to drag him from there. And we shouldn't get caught. This is good. We could literally complete the main objective of this mission straight away. But I know that there's some stuff in there that I need to steal as well, so I'm not a half a job Bob, am I, guys? I go in and I take everybody out and I completely wipe the place. Oh my god, oh my god, what's his, I can't think of his name. Oh my god, it's the Breaking Bad guy. It's Walter, it's Heisenberg. That's the one. It's Heisenberg, guys. We just killed Heisenberg. No. No. I'm sorry, Walter.
That can't be good.
Just waiting on him. Waiting on him. Boom. That's not Heisenberg. I don't know who he can be from Breaking Bad. Making quite a lot of movements here, guys. Just trying to see if there's another way in. Or like... Huh? Yeah, definitely the whistle approach with this one. Who's coming now? Oh, it's the guy from In the Hat, literally. What the fuck? Grrr. Or is it? Nah, right, I have to whistle him again. Oh, he's onto us now. He knows. Boom, he's done. The other one's coming as well now, shit. Oh, he's totes gonna see that body. He doesn't, He didn't see the body. Really? Where's the... Oh, okay, yeah, the body was literally just in front of me, I think. Okay, so I think we've got one left. Just the one left now, guys. Was that the guy that's standing? Yeah, I thought... I knew it'd be him. I just knew it'd be him.
I know I heard something.
Didn't really need to whistle him over, but then again, I am trying to save bullets for, like, proper shootout missions. What is he doing? Mate, just come over. Just come over, my man. Boom. Oh, that failed. Right, okay, we're done. We just got to take the stuff and get ourselves out of here. I think there's one more thing around the corner. I've stopped picking the notes up because I don't actually, I'm sorry, but I don't feel like they are really a significant part of the game. So I'm sorry if they are, but I don't feel like they actually mean anything. They were interesting at first, but then like now, like you don't even get a collectible, I don't think, for picking them up. So I don't know. If I'm missing something, let me know in the comments, guys. But I'm not going to bother from now. Anyway, we've done all the damage, which is brilliant. We can go back now to talk to Bear. I don't think you guys want to watch this, but I was just prattin' about, basically. I wanted to give Heisenberg the proper burial, you know? Okay, he's a balding Heisenberg. But yeah, let's go and chat to Bear. Rate those parking skills out of 10, guys. Proper 10/10 parking skills, that.
Look at you making it extra tough for Bobby Bastion to cook up his shit.
What the fuck? I literally pressed X to speak to him. And it's glitched. Oh my god. Oh guys, we have a glitch. Hello lady. Okay. Go out and try again maybe. I have a funny feeling it ain't gonna... No. Oh guys, we've got a first glitch in the game. Jeez. Okay, so I went for a little... Oh my god, the parking skills are just getting worse. I went for a little drive around. So I'll give it a chance to, like, you know, reset and everything. Let's see. Okay, so we're able to press the... Oh, fuck, it's done it again. I think I need to restart the game, guys. So, apologies, but I'm going to have to end the episode here. Very, very sorry about that, guys. Not ideal. I do apologize, but yeah, massive glitch in the game. Anyway, we finished off, like, doing all the stuff for Bear, so it's literally now a matter of going to take out Bastion. Was that his name, I think, maybe? Something like that. So, yeah, we're going to go take him out in the next episode. Obviously, I'll just take this time to thank you all very much for sticking around, you know, liking and being a subscriber. It means a lot to me. If you are new and you haven't subscribed already, please do so, guys. I'm currently around the 1,000 mark. I don't know what I'm going to be on by the time I actually upload this video. But yeah, you know, to hit that is going to be massive. So once I actually have done it and I'm recording the video, obviously I'll thank you. And I will be doing a 1,000 subscriber giveaway, a 1,000 subscriber probably Q&A as well, if you want to see that. So check my social media links out, guys, in the description down below. I have merch as well on there as well now, so I don't know what I'm chatting here. But yeah, anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching. Obviously, leave a like rating as well on the video if you did enjoy. Drop any comments that you've got in general as well. That'd be massively appreciated. And I'll see you all in the next video.